I found that sometimes I'm able to control a dream, or sometimes I'm able to direct myself before going to sleep to dream about a certain subject, and sometimes not. The important thing was to see your hands in a dream. And I made an effort to do this a number of times. And only a couple of times did I succeed in actually seeing my hands. And to me, one of the most important new facts about dreams is that they are a biologic necessity. They have made experiments of waking people up whenever they start to dream. They can tell by the rapid eye movements and also by the brain waves. The brain waves of dreams are very much like the brain waves of people when they're awake. And if they keep interfering with the REM sleep as a dream sleep, very soon the subject will show all the symptoms of sleeplessness, no matter how much dreamless sleep they allow. And eventually it will be fatal. It's within 2 weeks or so. So we know now that dreams are a biological necessity, which means they must serve a very important function. Next step is to go into space to leave the planet. We're not there yet. Here we have an artifact weighing about 170 pounds that cannot exist outside of a very specialized environment. It's sort of a whole aquarium. The official space programs, how do they propose to solve this? Well, they're going to move this whole artifact, the human artifact, in its environment from one place to another. It wouldn't occur to them to start from the other end. You have an object, X, that's the human body, and you want to transport X, say, from Earth to space, from E to S. And X is heavy, and it can only live in a whole medium. So why not alter X, reduce its weight and its dependency on its medium? That would seem to be a logical approach to the problem. This would not occur to the official program because they accept the human artifact with all its limitations. In effect, they accept the limitations imposed by Christianity, by what Crowley calls the slave gods. Much too dense for space conditions. We have a model to hand, and that is less dense. In fact, almost weightless, and that would be the astral or dream body. So the function of dreams may be to prepare us for space, and that is why they are a biological necessity. But we're not there yet.
interval is now underway. T-minus 15 seconds.
Zero program. grown used to wonders in this century. It's hard to dazzle us. We've grown used to the idea of space, and perhaps we forget that we've only just begun. We're still pioneers. Sometimes painful things like this happen. It's all part of the process of exploration and discovery. It's all part of taking a chance at expanding man's horizons. The future doesn't belong to the faint-hearted. It belongs to the brave. Nothing ends here. On this day, 390 years ago, the great explorer Sir Francis Drake died aboard ship off the coast of Panama. In his lifetime, the great frontiers were the oceans, and a historian later said he lived by the sea, died on it, and was buried in it. Well, today, we can say of the Challenger crew, their dedication was, like Drake's, complete. We will never forget them, nor the last time we saw them, as they prepared for their journey and waved goodbye and slipped the surly bonds of earth to touch the face of God. Thank you.